Hello viewers, I am Mahesh from bsc2nsc.com. In this video, I will be explaining about options. So I am going to make a series of videos about options, and this is the very first video. And in this video, we will be explaining about the basics. What is an option contract? So let's get started. Okay, so these are the topics that I will be covering in this video. So it is basics of how the option works with the real life example, what are the different terms used in an option contract, and we will also discuss about an example of a stock option, and at high level what are the different factors influencing the premium. This is at a high level, and in the subsequent videos I will explain each of these factors in more detail. Again, the last one is option chain. Why one has to look at option chain before trading in options. Moving on, okay, real life example. Okay, assume you wanted to buy a house by end of this month, not immediately, in a multi-story building. And the current market price is 80 lakhs, that is 8 million. Because that is the rate in which the builder managed to sell another house. So that is the current market price. You anticipate that the price will appreciate by end of this month to 81 lakhs. That is your assessment of the appreciation by end of this month. So you sign a contract with the builder to reserve the house for you, so he should not sell the house to anyone else for till end of this month. For him to do that, you pay him a token advance of 10k, saying you will buy the house for 81 lakhs by end of this month. So you are giving the builder, you are giving a 1 lakh extra to the current market price so that he will agree. Okay, you have signed the contract. Now let us consider three possible scenarios by end of this month. Scenario 1, as you anticipated, the builder managed to sell another house in the same floor for 81 lakhs, which means that is the current market rate. So your assessment of the appreciation is perfect. So you decide to exercise the contract by paying him 81 lakhs and you get the house registered on your name. So you and the builder both are happy. This is scenario 1. Let us consider the next scenario. After you have signed the contract, say there are 4 weeks till end of this month, you signed the contract at the beginning of the month. In 2 weeks time, government or the railways department makes an announcement that they are planning to lay a railway track next to the building where you plan to buy. So when such thing happen, usually the real estate the prices will go down, because no one will wish to stay just near the railway track, because the trains will be running throughout the day, you will not be able to sleep at night. Take an example that the market rate crashes to 60 lakhs from what was currently 80 lakhs. So your assessment went wrong completely. So what you do, just because you have paid 10,000, you will not buy the house for 80 lakhs as you agreed in the contract. What generally you do, you just let go of the contract and you take the 10k loss. You don't buy that house because its value has depreciated now. So you are booking a loss of 10k, that is 100% of the capital that you have given to the builder. So this is scenario 2, where the builder made 10k just by waiting for a month holding the house to sell it to you. But the builder cannot, the one thing to note here is in the contracts, the builder cannot force you to exercise the contract. So meaning the builder cannot ask you to pay 81 lakhs. Only if you wish to exercise, you can exercise, but the builder cannot force you. That is the main thing that you need to understand. Let us go to next scenario. Scenario 3. After you have signed the contract, in 2 weeks time, let's take a different case where a big builder announces that a big shopping mall is going to come in that area. So the real estate prices will appreciate much higher than what you anticipated. Say the price goes to 90 lakhs. So now you have signed a contract for 81 lakhs, you can go ahead and exercise the contract and you can get the house registered on your name by paying him just 81 lakhs. So what is the actual profit that you make? 8.9 lakhs. That is the difference between 90 lakh, that is the current market rate, and your contract rate of 81 lakh, but you already paid him 10k. So that we have to subtract. So 8.9 lakhs is the total profit that you made by signing that contract. Okay, now let us discuss the terms used in this agreement and how that will be reflected in the stock options or index options that we will discuss subsequently. Spot price 80 lakhs, that is the current market price. Strike price 81 lakhs, the price on which the contract is signed. Because this is the price at which you as an investor and the builder as a seller has agreed to exchange the goods. Here the goods is house. So you both agree on a price. So that is the strike price. In terms of stocks or index, the strike prices are decided by the stock exchanges, mostly by the NSE, because people trade in NSE future options than BSE. So NSE will determine for each of the stock what should be the different strike prices on which one can trade. Premium, this is another term used. This is the 10,000, the token advance that was paid by the investor to the builder. Quantity, so we plan to the buyer plan to buy just one house, but in case of stock option, stock or index options, it will be done in lots. And again, the size of the lot will be determined by the exchange based on the lot size, I mean based on the contract size, and that will be adjusted, either incremented up or brought it down based on the changes in the stock or index price. These things exchange will take care. Expiry date. So every contract should have an end date, and in our market, the last Thursday of the every month is the expiry day. And in India, we follow European style options. That is why in the options, we have the term CE for call option and PE for the put option. E denotes the European style of options, where the contracts can be exercised only on the expiry day, not before that. What is the underlying asset in this example that we discuss? It is the house. So in the case of stocks, that will be the actual stocks, that is the asset on which the option contracts are made. Okay, the main thing that to be noted in options is only the buyer can decide whether to exercise the contract or not. Seller cannot force a buyer to exercise. Okay, now let us take a stock option example. We have seen something in real life. Now let us go into the stock markets. Okay, ITC, the current market price or the spot price is 158. These are just examples. There is an investor who wants to buy 2400 quantity of ITC for delivery for long term, and he is expecting the price to go past 170 by end of this month. That is the assessment made by the investor. So there are 4 weeks in this month. So the investor thinks it will go up more than 12 rupees from the current price. That is his assessment. But investor doesn't have the money to buy immediately at 158, that is the current market price. But he will get the cash only by end of this month. So what he can do, if the price goes above 170, he will not have money. He can arrange funds only to buy the stocks at the price of 170. So what he can do is, he looks at the option contract. There's a call option with a strike price of 170, trades at a premium of 3, and the lot size is 2400 for ITC. Investor simply buys the call option, which will give him the right to buy 2400 quantity of ITC at 170 rupees. On expiry, that is the last Thursday of the month. In case if the Thursday happens to be a market holiday, then the Wednesday prior to that will be the expiry day. If Wednesday is also holiday, then the Tuesday. So it goes back like that. So on the expiry, if the investor prediction is right and the ITC settles at 180 rupees, he can still buy at 170 by exercising the option contract. and the call option seller need to deliver 2400 quantity of the shares to the option buyer at 170 rupees only, because that's what the contract is signed. So the investor is happy, but his prediction went right. He bought for 170 and the current price is at 180. Well, let's take the another scenario. If the investor prediction went wrong and ITC settles at 160 only, not 170 that he anticipated, the investor will simply forego the contract, because current market is at 160. He don't want to buy at 170 just because he has spent 7200 in buying the option contract. So he will just forego the contract and the seller makes that money as the profit. So investor will directly buy 2400 quantity from the market itself, because the investor anyways he has the fund to buy at 170 and he is buying at 160 itself. So the loss that he is having is the premium that he paid to buy the call option. Option traders currently doesn't wait till expiry to exercise the contract. These option contracts are used as trading instruments. Say for example, if an option call option buyer buys the option at 3 rupees, if it goes to 4 rupees in 2-3 days time, he'll just simply book the profit. Nobody currently is exercising these contracts to take delivery of these stocks. This is made purely speculation. SEBI wants to control it. So what SEBI has done is, they made the entire stock derivatives, that is stock futures and stock options, to be compulsorily settled physically, which means if you are holding a option contract which expires in the money, I will explain what is in the money, out of the money in the subsequent videos. If it is in the money, then you cannot settle in cash. You have to take delivery of the goods in case if you are a option call option buyer. Okay. Now, let us move on to discuss about the factors influencing option premium. We discussed 3 rupees as the premium. So, what are the different factors? This is at high level. We will discuss in detail about these factors in the subsequent videos. Number of days remaining in the expiry, that is called as theta. Amount of change in the option premium with respect to the changes in the spot price, so that is delta. Prevailing market conditions impacting the spot price, any event or news. In this example, when we discussed about ITC, assume there is a quarterly result coming up. If the company is posting results which is exceeding the market estimates or the analyst estimates, then the price will shoot up a lot. So which means there can be a big movement on the stock, either on the upside on very good results or on a bad results, it can go down. So this is the volatility. So that is measured in VIGA. So when the volatility is high, the option premium will be higher. Once the event is crossed, the volatility will drop, so the option premiums will reduce. So this is another factor that will influence the option premium. Any option premium, you can break that into two: intrinsic value and time value. We will discuss again further in the subsequent videos on how the premium is combined with intrinsic and time value, some examples. Okay. Option chain. Many traders are not using option chain. Option chain, anyone who trades on options, not for intraday, but for people who take positional calls, they have to check option chain. This will give you very good idea on whether the overall sentiment is bullish or bearish, where are the support levels, resistance levels. So give support and resistance levels. So I will show you an example now on how to identify the support and resistance on the current expiry by using option chain. This is only meaningful when there is enough volume. In India, currently the stock options are not liquid. Hardly some 10 stocks have very good volume where you can use the option chain. Examples like Tata Motors, Ashok Leyland. Most of the stocks doesn't have enough volume. So be careful when you trade in those stock options. Total open interest. So this will tell you whether the current expiry is going to be bullish or bearish. So you can interpret. Again, I will show you with an example. And in the current video description, I will have provide the link where you can just straight away access the option chain of NSE website. not everybody will know how to access the option chain, and there I have given the link that you can check it. Now let us go to the option chain. Say here NSE India. Okay, I still use old website, so let me go to the old NSE website. Go to live markets and you will see option chain. Click on equity derivatives. So the default one that you get is for Nifty, that is index options. Nifty, Nifty 80, Bank Nifty, Nifty 80 no one trades, so it is Nifty and Bank Nifty. And if you want specific stock, you just have to type the stock here, name here. Say for example, let us type Ashok Leyland and click on go. This will open up the option. So Ashok Leyland current market price is 46.85. So these are the put options. On the right hand side, left hand side, you have the call options. If you just scroll down, go directly to the bottom, you will see the total open interest on the call side and the total open interest on the put side. When call open interest is higher than the put, then that expiry is going to be a bearish one. This is just one level of interpretation using the overall total open interest. If calls are higher, it is bearish. When puts are higher, it is bullish. Okay, now if you just go here, you can see the maximum open, the open interest, and the maximum value is present for this particular strike, that is 40 rupees, followed by 45, which means there is support available at 45. If that is broken, then the next support is at 40 rupees. On the call side, when you go, the highest value is present in 50, followed by 55. So as of now, the immediate resistance is at 50, followed by 55. And you can see here, there are so much like million, 2 million, 1 million, another million here, even 52.5, there's 1.3 million. Meaning, upside is limited. The stock is currently, it can trade between the range of 40 rupees, that is the maximum open interest on the put side, and 50 rupees the maximum open interest on the call side. So this 10 rupees is the trading range for this expiry with the current data. So this is just one level. You can look at the chart to identify the support and resistance levels. So this is something that you can do without even checking the charts. So this is at high level on the option chain. So on the subsequent videos, we will discuss further. And thank you for watching. Bye.